large models have huge potential for data analysis. Today, we'll cover how to use Llama 3 with Pandas AI and Ollama. We run this model locally. We won't leverage any API key like OpenAI. The tools we'll use in this video are completely open source. Let me briefly explain these tools. When it comes to data manipulation, as you know, Pandas is king. You can think of Pandas AI as a smart version of Pandas. Pandas AI is nothing but a Python tool that allows you to explore, clean, and analyze your data using generative AI. This means that you can chat with your data using this tool. Cool, right? Another amazing tool in generative AI is Ollama. As you know, it's difficult to work with large models locally. This is where Ollama comes into play. Ollama helps you run LLMs locally. Awesome, right? Here is the app we create. First, we load our dataset. The dataset we'll use is the Titanic dataset. Here, we'll enter our prompt to talk to our dataset, and then the app will return a response. This is a simple app but great to see the power of Llama 3. Let's take a look at the topics we'll handle. First, we'll create a virtual environment and then install the tools we'll use. Next, we'll initialize Llama 3 with Ollama. After that, we'll load the dataset and then we'll build the app. Lastly, we'll chat with the dataset using Pandas AI. Nice! We've seen the topics we'll cover. Let's go ahead and start with the setup. To write our codes, we're gonna use the VS Code editor. Now, let's create a virtual environment. To do this, we're gonna use conda. Let's write conda create dash n, let's name gen AI. Let me press enter. I already created this. After that, we're gonna activate this environment. Conda activate gen AI. Here you go. Our environment is ready to use. The next step we're gonna do is install the tools we'll use. To do this, let's create a requirements.txt file. We're gonna click on the new file and then name it requirements.txt. Okay, let's write the libraries we'll use here. To work with Pandas AI, let's write Pandas AI. Next, to build the app, we'll use Streamlit. Let's write Streamlit. Okay, these tools are enough to build the app. We're gonna now install this. It's simple to do this with pip. Let's type pip install -r requirements.txt. Let me press enter. Here you go. Our tools are ready to use. To write our codes, we're gonna create a Python file. Let me click on the new file and then give a name. Let's say app.py. Yeah, our file is ready. So far, we created a video environment and installed the tools. Let's go ahead and initialize the model with Ollama. When it comes to working with LLMs locally, Ollama is king. These tools allow you to run open source LLMs, Llama 3 and Mistral. Trust me, it's very easy to use Ollama. All you need to do is download it from the website and then install it on your computer. After installing, you can use Ollama in the terminal. First, let's start it. Let's go to the terminal and then write Ollama serve. I already started Ollama. Ollama is ready to use. You can use many large models with Ollama. Let me show you these models. Let's click the models. There you go. Here, you can choose any model you want. It is a piece of cake to load a model with Ollama. To install a model, we're gonna use the terminal. Let me show you. Let's say we wanna install Llama 3. Ollama pull Llama 3. Let me press enter. There you go. As you can see, Llama 3 is loaded. You can see the install models with this command. Ollama list. There you go. As you can see, I loaded many models. The model we'll use is the Llama 3 8b version. Awesome. Ollama is ready to go. What we're gonna do now is initialize the model with Ollama. To do this, we're gonna use the local LLM class. First, let's import this class. From Pandas AI LLM local LLM import, let's type local LLM. Okay, what we're gonna do now is instantiate an LLM object by specifying the model name. To do this, we're gonna use compatibility. This helps the app to connect to Ollama. Let's write model equals local LLM. Let's connect Ollama API base equals HTTP localhost 1144 3, 4/V1. Okay. Next, let's specify the model. Model equals let's pass llama 3. Nice. Our model is ready. Let's go ahead and initialize the app with Streamlit. First, let's import this tool. Import Streamlit as st. Next, let's give the app a title. st.title let's pass data analysis with Pandas AI. After that, let's run this app. To do this, in the terminal, let's write streamlit run app.py. Let me press enter. Yeah, the app opened automatically in the browser. This is simple, right? You can see the title here. Let's go ahead and create a widget to load the dataset. To do this, we can use the file uploader method. Let's say uploaded file equals st.fileuploader. Let's give a text. Upload a CSV file. Next, let's specify the file type. Type equals CSV. Okay, nice. We created a widget. Let's test this widget. Go to the app and then click rerun. There you go. To load the dataset, let's click over here. And then select our dataset. After that, click open. Yeah, the file is uploaded. Easy peasy, right? Let's go ahead and take a look at the first rows of the dataset. To do this, let's use the if statement. If uploaded file is not none. After that, let's convert data into the Pandas data frame. First, we're gonna import Pandas. Import Pandas as PD. Next, let's read the dataset. Data equals pd.read CSV. Let's pass our variable, uploaded file. Now, let's write the first rows. st.write. Let's pass data. Dot, let's give 3. Let's test the app. To do this, let's go to the app and then click rerun. There you go. You can see the first rows of the Titanic dataset. What we need to do now is convert the dataset into smart data frame. To do this, we're gonna use the smart data frame class. Let's go back and write from Pandas AI import smart data frame. Next, let's get an object from this class. Df equals smart data frame. Let's pass our data. Let's set the config parameter. Let's pass LLM. Let's give our model. Nice. Our smart data frame is ready. Next, to get the input from the user, let's create a text area. Prompt equals st.text area. Let's give enter your prompt. Nice. Our text area is ready. What we're gonna do now is create a button. For this, let's use the button method with the if statement. If st dot let's call button method, let's give generate. When pressing this button, we wanna run the prompt. If prompt, if the prompt is true, let's display a message while running the code. To do this, let's use the spinner method using the with keyword. With st.spinner, let's give generating response. Now, all we need to do is return the response. To do this, let's write st.write. Let's invoke the chat method for a response. df.chat, let's pass prompt. Awesome, our app is ready. Now, it's time to make inferences. Let me go to the app and then click rerun. There you go. All we need to do is write the prompt to chat with the dataset. Let's write how many rows and columns are in the dataset. Let me click on the generate button. Yeah, the app is up and running. Voila! We got the output by talking to the dataset. Amazing, right? Now, we can explore our dataset using this app. Let's further learn the average age. What is the average age? Let me click generate. There you go. The average age is about 29. Let's go ahead and find out how many people have more than 3 siblings. How many people have more than 3 siblings? Let me press generate. There you go. There are 30 people with more than 3 siblings. Let's move on and wanna see many people died and how many survived. How many people died and how many survived? Let me click generate. There you go. Here are the numbers of people who survived and died. This was very easy to find out with Llama 3, right? Let's go ahead and wanna calculate the percentage of surviving passengers by gender. Return the percentage of passengers by gender. Let me click generate. Yeah, it's done. The percentage of male passengers is 64, and for female passengers, the percentage is 35. As you can see, it's easy peasy to explore the dataset with Llama 3 using Pandas AI. Let's go ahead and plot charts to understand the dataset. Let's type draw a bar chart of the sex column. Let me click generate. There you go. As you can see, men more than women. Okay. Let's go ahead and wanna plot a pie plot. Plot a pie chart of the P class column. Let me click generate. It's done. Here is the pie chart. You can see the percentage here. Let's go ahead and wanna visualize the distribution of the fair column. Visualize the distribution of the fair column. Let me click generate. There you go. Here is the distribution of the fair column. Now we wanna plot the histogram of the age column. Draw the histogram of the age column. Let me click generate. There you go. Here is the distribution of the age column. Let's go ahead and plot a histogram of the fair by sex. Draw the histogram of the fair column separated by the sex column. Let me click generate. There you go. Here is the distribution of the fair column by sex. You can plot any chart you want. Lastly, let's wanna plot the heat map chart of numerical variables. Draw the heat map of numerical variables. Let me click generate. There you go. Here is the heat map chart. Note that garbage in, garbage out. So good prompt means good output. You may need to try a few prompts to find a good one. Yeah, that's it. In this video, we covered how to use Pandas AI with Llama 3. To show this, we built an app step by step with Streamlit. Hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and leave a comment. See you in the next video. Bye for now.